Yes, kung mukha po kung nasa gitna ng karagatan, I am right now here in the Disney Cruise Line and we're heading back to Miami. And in this video, pag-uusapan natin is about failure. May nalugi ka bang negosyo? May produkto ka bang hindi bumenta? Hindi ba kumikita yung negosyo mo? Let's talk about that! Let's go! Okay, now let's talk about one of topics na hindi masyadong napag-uusapan or sabihin na natin hindi binibigyan ng attention, and that is about failure. Well, unfortunately, you know, there's no success if there's no failure. Sabi nga nila, you cannot say that you are a warrior if you've never been into war, if never been wounded or hurt, right? If you study the most successful entrepreneurs in the world, and I can guarantee you that in their stories, they're gonna share with you some of the mistakes that they made, the failures that they made, the money that they've lost, dahil kasama po talaga yon sa pagnenegosyo. And today, I'll share with you guys some of the insights that I learned and some of the things also that I keep hearing from many of the entrepreneurs na ating pong natulungan, from someone who would like to start a business or someone na kumikita na siya pero they're not making that much, from someone who would like to move to a multi-million level business. Yun po yung ating pag-uusapan today. One, or if not the most important thing that you need to understand about failure, is it is, whether you like it or not, it will be part of your journey as an entrepreneur. So since hindi mo naman siya maiiwasan, might as well you rewire your definition of failure. Rewire ibig sabihin that you change the way you see things pag dumating ang failure. Because many people, they try to avoid failure. Sino ba naman ang gusto, if you think about it? But then as I've said, if you want to become successful, you have to understand that it is part of your journey. So if you will rewire the way you see, the way you define failure, it will give you more joy and fun and even excitement. I'm gonna give you an example. When I was starting in my online business, one of the things that I realized that maraming negosyo that when you start, akala mo ang mga steps lang na gagawin is just a few, right? And then when you start doing the business, you start running the business, you start to realize na hindi pala siya ganun kadali ng inaasahan mo, right? So one of the things that, again, you have to rewire your mind is you have to understand that there is a process involved in building a business. So the first thing, if you start any business or whatever business that you are in right now, meron po siyang proseso. Because most, they are just simply excited with the result. Wanna make more money. I wanna become a chillionario. Okay? Yun agad yung nasa isip nila, without understanding, hey, that before I even start this kind of business, this Wednesday consulting business or an online business, things that I teach to people, you have to understand that there's a process. So one of which is learning the process, understanding, education, and it may take some time. That is why I keep advising people na mayroong mga full-time job is, in the beginning, they keep their job, their salary as a safety net while they understand the business, because again, there is a process, there is no instant result, which unfortunately, most people, yun yung gusto nilang isipin, right? Na pag ginawa ko tong negosyo ko na to, if I made an effort, dapat kinakailangan may resulta agad ako. Well, unfortunately, in most cases, that's not gonna happen. One of the things that I rewired, so to speak, my mind is this. That if I'm having difficulty into a certain things, for example, say, understanding Facebook ads, for example, in the beginning, and I'm getting overwhelmed sometimes, and I have a lot of things that I need to learn, and I find it difficult, one of the things that I rewired in my head is this. That if I'm having difficulty, if I'm having some challenges, so are my competitors. So in other words, nai-excite ako whenever I face some challenges and obstacles, because I know that my competitors are feeling the same way too. And having said that, all I have to do is just keep pushing. Keep pushing through whatever, you know, challenges na makaharap ko, because I know that if I gonna continue with this, most of my competitors will give up, and guess who's gonna win, right? Again, failure is really a recipe for success, and if you will not give up, you will see the result, you will reap the reward. Another thing with failure is this. You know, by nature, we would like to stay in our comfort zone, right? We want to do the same thing over and over again. We don't want too high. We don't want it too low. We just want like this smooth sailing, right? Funny thing, I'm right here in the middle of the ocean. If you are not failing often, if you've been going through life like you're in smooth sailing, then I gotta tell you, you're not trying hard enough. That is right. You're not trying hard enough. I'm not saying that you try to make stupid mistakes, but if you're not making mistakes at all, then you're not trying hard enough. You're just simply daydreaming. You just simply want success, but unfortunately, again, you're not trying hard enough. Then how could you possibly succeed in life knowing that success is outside of your comfort zone, is often outside your comfort zone, which means you have to go out there, be uncomfortable, and be ready to make mistakes. Another thing, insight and rewiring that I learned about failure is this. There are really no failure. You are only failure if you don't get up after you make a mistake. There is no really failure. It's only temporary defeat. That's one thing you need to work on. That's one thing you need to think about it. It's only temporary defeat. So again, if you created a product, walang bumili. If you made a marketing plan, it didn't work out. If you gave up on that point, then yes, you are a failure. Whenever I make a mistake, I just wanna think, what are the things that I can change from here? Right, so all those mistakes are just optimization data. You optimize things. Sabi nga nila, yung aeroplano, when a plane takes off, hindi naman siya just a straight line. You go from point to point to point. And that is something that you need to understand, that you keep changing, you keep twisting, you keep changing until you reach your destination. That is also, my friend, it's very important. I'm gonna end in this video that you have this community of people who understands you. If you look around, most people just give up on their dreams. They give up on their ambitions. Marami magsasalita, you know, I want to do this, I have big dreams and all, but if you're gonna watch their action, it will tell you the truth. But they have given up on their dreams and ambition. So that is why in my program, in many of my courses, I have Facebook group. Right? These are people who gather together. We even have meetups so that these people will encourage you if things didn't go as planned. It's very, very important. We have a Facebook group. We have a mga group chats. We have mga local events, face-to-face events, because it gives you, again, this community cheering you, excited for your success, and they are genuinely happy to see you succeed because we belong in this one whole family, or we belong in this one community. So in this video, my friend, I'm asking you, or I'll ask you, do you belong into a certain group? Do you belong into a certain community that drives success, that have big dreams, have big ambition? If not, then that is what your job for today after watching this video is: go out there, reach out to people, be part of this like-minded community. Okay, so that's it for today. Again, thank you for watching and have a great day. Wait, before you go, do not forget to click that red subscribe button below. I appreciate it. Thank you for watching.